Oh, wow. Look at that beautiful weather here in Kentucky. January 4th, 2018, Eastern Kentucky. I mean, it looks more like, well, excluding the mountains and the weather, it feels like Michigan, my home state of Michigan. It's cold, 15 degrees outside. It's been like this for a couple weeks. It's cold all over the country. And it's just... It's even, I think it was like 47 degrees in Tampa one of these days. I mean, come on, Tampa. What do they even do when it gets that cold in a place like Tampa? Anyway, guys, welcome to the Dimcat channel. I want to talk about politics. I want to talk about pop culture, a number of things. The whole Bannon-Trump feud. Bannon, of course, was a chief strategist for Donald Trump. He pretty much helped Donald Trump get into office. He was very much in Breitbart, this right-wing news source, alt-right, whatever you want to call it, which is a place I often go to. I used to, at least. He pretty much ran that. I think he was the founder of that. Well, he pretty much ran it. He wasn't the founder. He ran it for a while. He was a big contributor to that. And at some point recently, well, obviously he was part of the Trump campaign and part of the Trump administration. He got canned. He got fired. Trump let him go. And recently, some of his quotes came out in some book talking about some meeting that Trump Jr. had with some Russians during a campaign. Apparently, this happened during a campaign, and he referred to the meeting as treasonous. Which is kind of interesting, because if he really felt that way, then why the hell did he stay on a campaign? Which, you know, Trump said the guy was pretty much out of his, he lost his mind. And to me, I just ignore this foolishness. Just like Trump talking about, you know, he's got a bigger button than than the guy here in North Korea, the Kim in North Korea. I mean, come on. You know, I don't take everything this guy does that seriously. But, you know, I am seeing some things that look good. You know, for example, according to Challenger Gray and Christmas, in 2017, they saw a 20% drop in layoffs. 20% drop in layoffs and the amount of people amount of jobs cut. 20% drop from 2016. This is the lowest they've seen, the lowest amount they've seen since 1990, which is awesome news. Speaking of news, okay, so there are two major chip flaws in PC processors. Apparently billions of devices, not millions, billions. Pretty much everything made in the last 15 years is affected by these two major flaws. One of the flaws involved those Intel chips, which are pretty much everywhere. Another one pretty much involves pretty much all chips in general. So they're talking about on the news how they have to replace some of the hardware and some of the operating systems like Windows and whatever. Microsoft are working on changes to their operating systems to repair the security flaw. Apparently this makes it easier for people to hack smartphones and computers and all this other stuff. How is this actionable intelligence? Like, what the hell are we going to do? It seems like a one big ploy to get people to run out and buy, oh, these new computers. I'm pretty sure about 6 months from now, they're going to come out with a whole new processor that's supposed to be so much more secure and all this other stuff. Just, and this whole thing is just one big ploy to get people to buy more processors. That's just my thought on the whole mess. You guys tell me what you think. So now DOJ, the Department of Justice, is taking a fresh look, a so-called fresh look at the Hillary Clinton email scandal. And it's like, come on, guys. If you didn't do anything the first time and then the second time, you're not going to do anything now. I mean, just stop looking if you're not going to actually do your job and do something. It's just ridiculous. They're going to take another look. I mean, come on. They deleted 33,000 emails. Thousands of emails, okay? If any other person did that, they would be in prison. It's just that simple. It's not that complicated. Anyway, going back to that meltdown story, the whole Intel processor situation, turns out Intel's CEO liquidated the maximum amount of stock possible, legally permitted, 5 months after learning about this security flaws in their processors. $39 million worth of Intel stock. Paid. And I'm willing to bet, of course, the public didn't know about that, but this person was able, this guy, Brian Kasowitz, whatever, was able to delete his stock, able to sell his stocks. And it's this world is just unreal. Like, if I was a alien, if I was an extraterrestrial looking at this world, I just wouldn't even believe it was real. This whole world would seem like some crazy TV show to me. Anyway, not so surprising news. Sears is going to shut down 103 stores, including a bunch of Kmarts. Here's what I got to say about Kmart. Just stop it. Just shut them all down. Nobody goes to Kmart. I feel like they're just dragging a dead horse here. The Kmart is never going to make it. It's over. It's been dead for, I don't know, 10 years or 10 or 20 years. Why are those stores still open? It seems like they're going to just shut down, like they're turning off one light at a time instead of just shutting off all the lights in a store, in a building, you know? Just let it go. It's not going to work. Nobody goes there anymore. What's the point? Speaking of retail, or kind of, Comcast fired 500 people just before Christmas as they were lobbying for tax cuts. Of course, the tax cut bill went through, the tax reform went through. They fired 500 sales people before Christmas. You know, here's the thing about Comcast. I think a lot of what's happening with Comcast and a lot of cable companies has a lot to do with what's going on with the NFL and the fact that people are just... They're not ordering cable TV anymore. Why order cable TV and pay $150 for 150 channels, and most of which you don't even watch, when you can just go ahead and get Netflix? Netflix and Hulu Plus. Those two things, you know, you spend like $22 on you get both of them, basically. No commercial breaks. You get Hulu Plus for about, what, $12, and then there's different plans for Netflix. You know, nine or 11 or $13 or whatever. You can pretty much get the $12 one and get HD stuff. For a very small amount of money, $22 or so, you can basically get all the content you really can watch in one weekend. You know, it's not like you're going to be watching it every single day, all day. You got to go to work, you got to do something else. That's more than enough content. Current TV shows, old TV shows, movies, all this stuff. I mean, you could add Showtime to your Hulu Plus. I think you can add HBO now if you want. It's still going to be cheaper than going out and trying to get some cable bundle with all these ridiculous channels you don't really need or watch. It's just ridiculous. So I think, and plus the NFL, their ratings have been dropping. And, you know, without sports, if people are boycotting the NFL because of their foolishness that's going on, if people are doing that, and the ratings are dropping, what incentive do people really have to get cable TV? You know, without live sports, you really don't have any incentive. You're better off just getting Netflix and Hulu. But anyway, speaking of television, I'm reading the comments about the X-Files, the 11th season premiere. Oh my God. You know, sometimes when people produce TV shows, they get to the 11th season, you just think, man, they should have just stopped a couple seasons ago. They probably should have stopped after 10. But anyway, some bizarre twist in the story. I don't even know if this is even worth talking about, really. I'm sorry, it's just too stupid. I mean, it's sad. I just had to mention it because it's just sad seeing like a really great TV show just go down the drain like this, man. I'm not even going to go there. It's just sad. Anyway, Taylor Swift. Okay, so people are commenting on her high ticket prices. I want to talk about this because I think too many acts are charging too much money for these concerts. And the reason why they're doing it is because they can't make money off of album sales like they used to. They're not selling the CDs like they used to. They're selling some MP3 albums, but they're not selling the product like they used to. They're relying a lot more on streaming. Actually, the music industry has actually had some growth this year, the second year in a row in which they had growth. Thanks to streaming. But I wonder how much money are these artists really making off of streaming? That's anyway, they're actually using that to calculate whether an album goes platinum or not, which I don't agree with. I think you just go by sales. People willing to spend money on a specific product, a specific set of songs. That's just the traditionalist in me, I guess. But anyway, there is some little growth in the music industry. But Taylor Swift, I went on. They had this program called Taylor Swift Ticks or whatever. And if you buy like a CD, you get like a boost or a credit or so. You get a better position in getting a ticket. Man, I went online. I saw that stuff. I was like, oh my god, $1,200 for for some VIP tickets. $1,200. Are you insane? I saw like 600, 500. I was like, oh my God. And those weren't even great seats, you know? It's like, they were good seats, but they weren't great seats. And I'm thinking like, who in the hell is going to be able to pay $1,200 to see anybody perform? I mean, that would have to be like Michael Jackson brought back from the dead for me to spend like $1,200 on a damn ticket. I mean, you know, it's like, this is crazy. And she's not the only artist doing this. It's like, whoa. You know, you see some of these prices, and it's like, man, this is like a really nice rifle type of money. I mean, this is like $1,200, man. You can have a lot of fun in Atlanta or Tampa. Or even Vegas, you know, take that money. Well, assuming you had the plane ticket or so, but man, you could have a lot of fun with that. Anyway, I'm not gonna go there, but I mean, for a concert, I like concerts, but man, it will take a lot to get me to spend that kind of money. Last weird story. So, Philip Morris, the makers of Marlboro and Marlboro Lights and L&M and other tobacco products, they're saying that they're gonna go smoke free. Their plan is to sell vapes and the smoke free products. They want to provide a better choice than cigarette smoking, the vapes, the e-cigarettes. That's eventually gonna replace all of the smoking cigarettes in the UK. The US, I don't think so. No way, especially here in Kentucky. They smoke a lot down here in Kentucky, a lot more than they do in Michigan. Yeah, that's one of those things that really surprised me. And chewing tobacco, that's a thing. I've never seen anybody chew tobacco until I came to Kentucky. But anyway, guys, these are my thoughts on... share your thoughts on any of these stories, and thank you for your comments in my last video. It was really, really eye-opening. It's funny when I do a video and I'm really proud of the video, and then people respond, I'm thinking like, oh man, they got some really good points. Maybe I was wrong. But I still like my last video, and I definitely enjoyed the comments. So thank you for watching, thank you for listening, and don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.